So here is the heart with the atria and ventricle. So here we have the right atria and this is the right ventricle, and here is the left ventricle, and behind that somewhat here is the this is the left atrium. So all these structures are shown in the 3D model of this human heart. Now what if we remove the right atrium as well as the left atrium? Now you can see that this is the right AV orifice, right atrioventricular orifice, and this is the left atrioventricular orifice. And from these AV orifices, the valves are protruding. Actually, the cusps or flaps of the valves are protruding. Now the right side has a tricuspid valve, meaning that the right heart has a valve that has three cusps, while the left heart has a valve that have two cusps. Why so? Now an intriguing mind might compel you to question that why the right side has three cusped valves and why the left side of the heart has two cusped valves. Why not opposite? That's a logical question, by the way. Well, actually, if you want to remember, it is just easy to remember. You can say that try to be right. Try to be right. It means right side has tricuspid three cusped valve, and the left side has bicuspid valve, which is also called mitral valve. The word mitral, it comes from the term mitre. Mitre means a particular shaped hat of a bishop. So that is why, because it looks like that hat, that is why it is called mitral valve, or because it has two cusps, so it is called bicuspid valve. Now I don't just want you to cram up that right side has three cusps valve. Actually, I want you to understand the logic behind this. I want you to have the basic concept. So in today's visual lecture, we will talk about that why the right heart has tricuspid valve and not bicuspid valve and vice versa. Hello, I am Dr. Aizaz from MedicoVisual.com. Welcome to this visual lecture. Now, if you just focus on these AV orifices, you can easily see that the right AV orifice, the AV orifice of the right heart, is relatively much larger as compared to the left AV orifice. Now, actually, if I tell you some boring numbers, if you, let's say, take a measuring tape and if you start measuring like this, starting from here and continue, and if you measure the circumference of this AV orifice like this, the circumference of this AV orifice according to Gray's anatomy in males is 11.4 centimeter, in females it is slightly lower. And compare this with the circumference of left AV orifice, which is just on an average, which is just 7 centimeter. So what you can see that the circumference of left AV orifice is much lesser as compared to the circumference of right AV orifice. So right AV orifice is larger as compared to left AV orifice. Of course, the diameter of these AV orifice is also different. The right AV orifice, its diameter would be greater as compared to the left AV orifice, but because of their irregular shapes, it is difficult to determine the diameter. So rather than putting the diameter, we simply tell about the circumference of this AV orifice. Now, one simple reason for the presence of tricuspid valve, the three cusped valve in the right heart, is that the AV orifice of the right heart is bigger. Well, simple as that, the AV orifice is bigger on the right side. So to compensate for that, we might need an extra cusp, an extra flap. So that is why the right heart has three cusps. Now this explanation might breed another question in your mind. Why the heck the right AV orifice is bigger as compared to the left AV orifice? Well, again, that is a logical question. Actually, there must be some reason for this. You see, everything in our body is purpose-built, and the heart is epitome of such intelligent design. So today we will dive a bit deeper into the sea of physiology as well to understand the concept. Now, if you look at the shape of these ventricles, this is the right ventricle. You can easily see that the right ventricle, it is somewhat triangular shaped. So here you can see that the shape of right ventricle is triangular. So it is somewhat like this. Here is the base. This one is the base of that triangle. And this one is the apex. Opposite to that, the left ventricle, it is somewhat tubular, or it is somewhat tube shaped or bullet shaped. So it means that because the right ventricle is triangular shaped, so this is the base of that right ventricle, and the base of right ventricle is naturally much wider as compared to the tube shaped left ventricle. And because the base of this right ventricle is wider, that is why the right AV orifice is wider. And because right AV orifice is wider, we need an extra cusp to compensate that. So that is the reason that we have tricuspid valve. That is most probable reason. Of course, we are not 100% sure, but that is the most likely reason. Now another question, that why the right ventricle is triangular shaped and why the left ventricle is shaped more like a tube. To understand this, I am gonna hide everything and we will go to a more simplified 3D model of the heart. So here we have a more simplified 3D model of the heart, and here we have left ventricle. This red one and this blue one is the right ventricle. And again, here in this diagram as well, you can see that you can see it more clearly, although this diagram is not anatomically correct, but it will help you understand the physiology and dynamics of these chambers of heart. So here you can see that the left ventricle, this is the left ventricle here, this left ventricle is shaped more like a tube or bullet shaped, while the right ventricle, it is shaped like a triangle, and of course the base of triangle is much wider, and that leads to a greater diameter and circumference of AV orifice on the right side. The second thing that you might have noticed in this 3D model, that the walls of left ventricle, they are much thicker as compared to the walls of right ventricle. The reason is simple, that because the left ventricle has to pump the blood throughout the body, and it needs to build much greater pressure because it has to pump against a greater resistance. So because it has to work hard, so it is more muscular, it is more powerful chamber. Opposite to that, the right ventricle does not has to pump the blood throughout the body. Rather, it has to pump the blood only to the lungs, which are lying very near and dear to the heart. So, and of course, they offer less resistance to blood flow. So, because right heart, right ventricle has to do much less work, so its walls are thinner as compared to the left ventricle. And because the walls of right ventricles are thinner, it means that it has more space to accommodate the blood. Its lumen is greater as compared to the left ventricle. Left ventricle's lumen is smaller as compared to the right ventricle. Well, actually, the left ventricle is slightly bigger than the right ventricle. If you see externally, the left ventricle is bigger than the right ventricle. But if we talk about the lumen of the ventricle, then the right ventricle has a greater lumen, has a bigger lumen, while the left ventricle has a smaller lumen. And of course, because of this, the surface area of the lumen of right ventricle is greater and the surface area of lumen of left ventricle is lesser, it is smaller. Why it is so? This is because the right ventricle, it has to produce less pressure. It has to produce less pressure, but left ventricle, because it has to pump the blood against a higher resistance throughout the body, it has to produce greater pressure. Now imagine two balloons. One balloon is smaller and the other balloon is larger. Now if you fill both of these balloons, smaller as well as larger, with the same volume of water, which balloon will have greater pressure inside it? The answer would be that the smaller balloon will have built up a greater pressure inside it because the surface area is less. The ratio of surface area to volume is much lesser in case of smaller balloon. But because this larger balloon has a greater surface area, it can accommodate more fluid, it can accommodate more water without exerting too much pressure on this water. Now let's assume that this is not the balloon, this is the right ventricle and this is the left ventricle. Now because right ventricle has a wider lumen, it causes less buildup of pressure inside it. While the left ventricle, it causes a buildup of high pressure inside it. Its wall exert greater pressure on the blood. While the walls of right ventricle, they do not need to generate too much pressure. So, they exert less pressure on the blood. Now, the second thing is that why this particular shape of these ventricles? Why the left ventricle is shaped like a triangle? The reason lies in the dynamics of both of these chambers. This concept has been pretty nicely elaborated by Walter F. Boron in his book Medical Physiology. And I will explain those concepts using the 3D illustrations and 3D animations. Right ventricle has this somewhat free wall and this wall is somewhat fixed. Now this free wall, it moves like this. And this leads to a generation of less pressure, but a good volume of blood will be pumped out as a result of such contraction. Opposite to that, if we focus on the left ventricle has a lot of circular muscles, and what these circular muscles will do that they will contract in such a way that the diameter of this tube-like left ventricle will be reduced, and it is just like squeezing a tube of toothpaste. While the contraction of right ventricle is like the movement of bellows that are used to air the fire. So let's see the animation first. Here you can see that how this free wall, it will come to meet a relatively fixed wall in case of right ventricle. And in case of left ventricle, the diameter is being reduced. Now you can see the movement of right ventricle is just like those bellows that are used to air the fire. And the movement of left ventricle, it is just like the squeezing of toothpaste from the tube. So that is basically it. That's why the right side of the heart has tricuspid valve. It is very simple. The right AV orifice is greater while the left AV orifice is smaller, and why it is so, that I have explained in a great detail. I hope you learned something. Thank you so much for watching this video. And if you like this video, please check out my course on development of CVS, the CVS embryology course. You will love that course.